Hey guys, what's up? It's Apple Critics from AppleCritics.com. In this video, I'm going to be talking about all the iOS 14 features that you need to know and just the super exciting features that will be coming very soon. So Apple's next generation iOS operating system preview is expected in June, and the final release will be coming in September 2020. So in this video, I'm going to be taking a deeper look at it. So iOS and iPadOS 14 are Apple's next operating systems for the iPhones and iPads. It's expected to debut in WWDC on June 22nd, and the iOS 14 full release is expected in September. So here are all the expected features. So first off will be the home screen. On the Apple Watch, Apple allows all of the installed apps to be viewed in a list, and that same feature will be coming on iOS 14. Here we have my Apple Watch. And you can see we have all the apps here, just like on the iPhone. But what we can do is actually have the list view just by simply holding down. And now you'll see that you have the option for a grid view or a list view. So we could just press list view. So this is what it will look like on iOS 14. You'll just have a list view that's in alphabetical order, and you'll be able to look at all your apps just like this. So that is essentially what iOS 14 will have. iOS 14 could also offer a home screen widget options just like on Android. We'll allow the widgets to be moved around freely just like app icons on the home screen. So that's another great feature. Now another one is that Apple is working on a fitness app for the iPhone, Apple Watch, and Apple TV that will let users download fitness related video that will walk them through various workouts. So it'll be good to see Apple having a fitness app, and the Apple Watch will be used to track progress throughout the workout routines, and the progress will also be displayed on the iPhone, iPad, and Apple TV. And there will be a variety of different workout types, including indoor running, cycling, rowing, stretching, core training, strength training, outdoor walking, dance, and yoga. So this will be really the app to have for fitness on your iPhone. Now the next features actually occur in the Messages app, and Apple is reportedly testing a range of new features in iMessages that will come to iOS 14. So the first one is a Slack-like mention system that will allow users to tag contacts with their name with an at symbol, so at Eric, for example. And then in a busy group chat, let's say you mute the conversation, but if someone mentions your name directly, then you'll be able to get a direct push notification since your name has the at sign and then your name. Now, another new feature that will be in the Messages app will be that Apple is working on a feature that will allow you to retract iMessages after sending them with the retraction visible to both parties. So what that means is you'll be able to send a message. So let's say, for example, hello. But if you said hello to the wrong person, you can unsend that message super quick. But then they'll see that you unsent the message, but they won't see what you said in the message. So they won't see that you said hello, but it'll say, let's say, for example, Eric, unsent a message, so you'll get a notification in that way. Now you'll finally be able to get typing indicators for group chats, so that will be very helpful because those iMessage group chats get crazy at times with not being able to tell who is typing, so it'll just be good to get that group typing indicator. Now another good feature is that you'll be able to mark messages as unread, which will allow them to retain the unread icon, so you won't forget that you haven't read that message yet. Now, the Activity app will have some changes, so watchOS 7 will bring a kids mode to the Apple Watch, and iOS 14 will have a tweaked Activity app to accommodate the new mode. Rather than tracking activity calories burn, the Activity app for the kids mode will track movement time, which is a healthier metric for children. So that's what will happen to the Activity app. Now, iOS 14 will actually have a new augmented reality app that goes by the name of Gobi. So that's a code name for it, so it could change. But the app is said to allow users to get more information about the world around them through augmented reality. Now, the app may feature integrations with Apple stores and Starbucks, which suggests users could do something like hold up an iPhone in an Apple store. Let's say, for example, you're doing that, and then what would happen is that you're able to view information about products. So AR experiences would be triggered via QR codes at tags in the area, and there's a possibility that iBeacons or Apple's AirTags could work as triggers. So the aforementioned Apple design QR codes have been found inside the Gobi app as references to a Gobi comparison shopping feature that could let shoppers compare items. There are also signs that the Gobi app could allow for promotions or content experiences based on specific locations. So the Apple Gobi app is looking like it's going to be the real deal. Now, another new feature is that you'll be able to set third-party apps as default. So starting on iOS 14, Apple may allow the iPhone and iPad users to set third-party mail, browser, and music apps as their default apps instead of their own. So that feature is huge. So instead of having the default, let's say, for example, mail app, you can have a third-party mail app as a default one. So that's good that Apple is finally allowing the users to have choice to have third-party apps as a default app. Now, Apple will include sleep tracking in the health app. So the sleep tracking feature rumored for the next generation Apple Watch will integrate into the health app on the iPhone, which will allow users to have a personalized sleep goal. And the health app will also offer recommendations for improving your sleep. So that's good as well. Now, shot on iPhone will be integrated into the Photos app. So let's say, for example, you're in the Photos app and you just take a photo and then you go to the photo right here. And then you just tap on the share options. There should be a button that will say shot on iPhone. And then once you have that shot on iPhone, what that means is that you can just press it and then it'll just enter that photo into a contest that Apple has that provides cash rewards for the winner. So whoever takes the best photo that's shot on their iPhone, then you can win a contest that Apple does. So Apple just wants to integrate that directly into the Photos app, just allowing the iPhone users once again to submit their photo results and see the challenge results in the app. So that's what Apple is planning to do. Now, Apple also may develop a full version of Xcode that runs on iPads, and the Xcode app could come out as soon as iOS 14. So the Apple leaker, John Prosser, said the Xcode is present in iOS 14, but is noting that there's also a hidden Xcode preview app that's present in iOS 13. So you may be able to code from your iPad instead of only Macs. Now, the Find My iPhone will gain a new notification feature that will provide alerts when someone doesn't arrive at a specific location at a specific time of day. So a parent can do something like set up an alert when their child arrives at school for a certain time. So if your child doesn't make it to school by a deadline, then an alert will be sent. Now, CarPlay is also getting some more iOS 14 support. That can include custom wallpapers displaying the wallpaper on the CarPlay interface. And the wallpapers could also be switched between light and dark mode based on the time of day. Now, the Car Key app, there's hints of the new Car Key API that were found in iOS 13.4, which would allow the iPhone to be used as a lock and unlock and start the car that has NFC capability. So you can just use your iPhone to start a car. So that will be super cool. And that's coming with the Car Key app. Now, sharing features will also be available for assigning the keys to friends and family members through the Messages app. So you can just text a friend or family member their ability to lock and unlock your car. Car Key would be an iOS 14 feature, will allow iPhone owners to use your devices as a physical car key. So BMW could possibly be the first partners based on code and images found on iOS 14. So that's really good. Now, the last features here are the smaller features. So Apple Maps may provide additional information for select businesses in iOS 14, such as specific Genius Bar services offered by the Apple Store, movie theaters with IMAX showtimes, and locations with discounts for children. So that's what Apple Maps will be providing. Now, the iCloud keychain will include warnings whenever a password is reused, which should help and encourage users to select different passwords for each login. Now, the Clips feature, Apple is working on a new feature that will allow third-party users to interact with content, with select content and experiences in third-party apps without having to have apps installed through a feature Apple has codenamed Clips. Clips are also designed to allow users to scan QR codes that are linked to an app, then interact with content from that app through a floating card on the screen. The card would offer up options to download the full version of the app from the App Store and open other content that has already been installed. Now, the Apple Pencil will be getting some updates. So there is a new Pencil Kit feature that will allow users to handwrite text in any text input field using Apple Pencil with the handwritten content then converted into a standard text before it's sent. So that's good. Now, the new HomeKit features will include a night shift for lights. So that means you can allow the HomeKit to adjust the color temperature of the HomeKit connected lights based on the time of the day. So early in the day, you'd want the light set at a certain amount of lighting, or let's say blue lighting, and then at the end of the day you can change it to a warmer tone. You also get facial recognition for cameras. So a new HomeKit secure video feature adds people for identification, which perhaps will allow security cameras to detect a specific people, distinguishing people in the family from strangers. And the HomeKit secure video already supports object recognition for things such as people, animals, and vehicles. Now, other notable features include custom voice synthesizers. So Apple appears to be exploring ways to let developers provide custom voice synthesizers on iOS through a framework called Voice Provider. Now, voice synthesizer extensions would be bundled with apps from the App Store, then can be used to replace the default speech voice, a feature that has the potential to be important for languages and dialects that Apple does not support. Now, Apple is planning to introduce support for third-party wallpaper packs in iOS 14, which would allow developers to create wallpaper options for the iPhone that would be able to be installed through the wallpaper section of the Settings app. So that's good that you'll get some third-party wallpaper integration. And Apple is said to be implementing the wallpaper categories that will allow users to better sort through the available wallpaper options. In terms of accessibility updates, iOS 14 could include accessibility updates such as a feature that will detect sounds like fire alarms, door knocks, doorbells, and more for people who have hearing problems. And there may also be a new feature that will allow the camera to detect hand gestures, and Apple would introduce audio accommodations that improve the audio tuning of AirPods and EarPods for people who have mild to moderate hearing loss. Now, last but not least, is the iOS 14 supported devices. So these are the rumored devices that will be compatible with iOS 14. So first off is the iPhone 11 Pro, iPhone 11 Pro Max, iPhone 11, iPhone XS, iPhone XS Max, iPhone XR, iPhone X, iPhone 8 Plus, iPhone 7, iPhone 7 Plus, iPhone 6S, iPhone 6S Plus, iPhone SE, and then the iPod Touch 7th generation. So those are all the iOS 14 compatible devices. So hopefully you thoroughly enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to leave a comment down below on what you think of iOS 14, what your favorite feature is. Be sure to smash the like button, smash the subscribe button, and also be sure to stay tuned as I will have the most iOS 14 coverage on all of YouTube. So be sure to check out all my social media profiles. I have an Instagram, a Facebook, and a Twitter profile. My username there is AppleCritics. And once again, subscribe for more great content, and thanks for watching.